In this case, there's no honor in being violent. No honor in unleashing feelings that refuse to stay silent. There's nothing worse than leaving your daughter more than frightened, but still, some would go beyond those limits to protect the family name. They're more than rigid. Sacrilege must remain dead and buried, and so it does under her name in the cemetery. Since she didn't heed his lecture, she wanted another guy, but he didn't let her. Forbidden love didn't create the rift. What did was death before dishonor. Instead of her happiness, what he had in mind was torture. Just wanting to make her scream led to the shock of raising a murdered teen, because for a split second, he forgot what being a father means. When the little princess fell from his eyes, while trying to live up to his vision, is how patriarchy kept her in prison, which was why he was unwilling to listen. Ever since finding out, he wanted her married off, now and not leave it to later, as the role of a wife can serve to police behavior, especially when they're still kind of young. Marriage is used to allay the irrational fear from parents of what their daughters may become. Independent, liberal, or traditionally less observant, detaching themselves from honor for someone like her, it was a burden that she carried on her shoulders, showing no sign of resistance, but anger brewed at her brother, who was treated kind of different. You can say better. A form of discrimination based on gender places the issue of choice point blank at the center, praying that he would accept the guy she was seeing, just two beautiful human beings who wanted to build a dream, but no. At that moment, he forgot what being a father means when he changed her room into a crime scene, showing how gender inequality can widen even further via twisted ideologies, preserving honor through murder. To justify the end with the blare of police sirens, the moral of the story: there's no honor in being violent.